Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, happy to be with you and CD as we get this thing going, give the folks at home something to keep their eye on.
The running game for both teams, because I think this is going to be an old-fashioned, old-school type of a game. Physical, who runs up front, who runs the ball the best and controls the clock, they will come out the victor.
They go play action here on first down. Is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hurt.
He's not a throw. Strikes by with the 45. And he will score. Touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that. First drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
But now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
Tucker with the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. On third down today, they've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This will be third and a mile. Working from the gun. It's Green. It's Green on one side by Tate. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15.
because this certainly feels like it's over after that drive.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You can see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
Tucker with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a right at about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take in the next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing game and game like this, and you knew it was last, it was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team. Just something to go about, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
11 more yards there. This methodical drive continues. On first down, Breeze. They're calling field and working the middle. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Now they got to get to the line quickly. On third down today, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. From the gun, it's Breeze. And this is going to be incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just go better and better.
They tripped him. That's going down the left side. It's a fumble. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. That's Happy Charles. You play the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it on the other side, is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
Now, I guarantee you, I know it was really excited. Fantasy owners.
Yeah.
Who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
Tucker now for the extra point. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. After surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. This will be taken in at the 1. And out of that return, here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest,
don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, he's at his aim again.
Exactly. It's a good green.
And for a 3rd time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Jamal Adams. Gets an interception return for a Rams touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Tucker now to add the point after. Tucker with the extra point. point, and the lead will swell by one more. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Puts his field at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game. To put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking, they think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Call me soon. 15. When I saw my first time.